As strange as this may sound, it's true. I found something that I agree with Newt Gingrich on. Take a look.
I believe the NRA has been too timid. A Gingrich presidency will submit to the United Nations a treaty that extends the right to bear arms as a human right for every person on the planet, because every person on the planet deserves the right to defend themselves from those who would oppress them, exploit them, rape them, or kill them. Far fewer women would be raped, far fewer children would be killed, far fewer towns would be destroyed if people everywhere on the planet had the right to bear arms, and far fewer dictators would survive if people had the right to bear arms everywhere on the
planet. Got to agree with them, and for the most part, I believe having more guns would create a freer world. Not safer. I'm not under any kind of illusion that more guns makes the place a safer world. It makes it a freer one. And I've always defended gun rights and gun ownership. But I do like his point about there being less rapes if everybody is armed. After all, the old feminist saying, dead men don't rape. And that's actually a very good point that does need to be made. But, as I said, I don't believe it would make the world a safer place, because more guns does not equal more safety. I would, however, agree that it would lessen the possibility of fascists standing up and being able to take power. I absolutely agree with that point. Now, I'm not going to go into the whole NWO thing, but I mean, more guns does equal more freedom. Depending on what you want to consider freedom, or consider the aims of the person having the gun, but I'm going to say a world with guns is more free than a world without it, depending on what that other world without would be. But for the world that we live in right now, more guns is more freedom and the ability to defend yourselves. I'm going to have to absolutely agree with that. Now, interestingly, this doesn't apply to all nations when it comes to bigger things like nuclear weapons. Newt Gingrich would not be saying, let's give Iran nuclear weapons in no way, shape, or form, or give Palestinians nuclear weapons, or anybody America just doesn't like nuclear weapons. Although there would be an element of fairness to doing that, because then nobody would shoot because nobody would shoot back. But then we'd be getting into a whole Cold War type argument. That's not really what this is about. But we can see the double standard here. He's advocating everybody have guns, but not every country having nuclear weapons. Now, it's true. The society in the world with the most guns is Somalia. And by no means is Somalia a safe place. It's a libertarian utopia, but it's not safe. And there's a ton of anti-libertarian stuff I could go into, but that's not the reason for this video. So clearly, more guns does not equal safe. But then again, I said that's not what I seek to get, a safer world through guns. Also, Afghanistan is a place with a very high rate of people who own guns, and it's also not really any safe. Not much safer than Somalia, but safer, you could say. One thing I would agree with would be giving guns to the third world. I think that would be a great thing to do. Arm the masses of the entire world. Well, we have an idea of what might happen. If we armed everybody in the entire world, the tyrants are going to get it. And I think one of those tyrants might just be the First World. I mean, I'm not intending to sound like a third worldist here, but we know what would happen if we armed everybody in the entire world. The First World would get it. And I know there's going to be some comment by some right-wing reactionaries and say, oh, I'm ready for anybody who comes and blah, 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 get black people out of my country or whatever it is he's going to say. But I would agree with that. If we did arm everybody in the entire world, the First World would be pretty much just put on notice to stop screwing around and stop doing the things they do. Well, specifically the United States. Because I sincerely doubt the U.S. military wants to go into a country where absolutely everybody is armed. I think that's something that they would like to avoid. But I think there's a very positive freedom that could come out of arming the third world. Despite everything I've said, I do believe in a world that will one day not have guns. But only because we won't need them. When we get to communism, the state is gone, money is gone, and all of that's been accomplished. There will be no need to have a gun. On the flip side of that, there will be no government, no one to take the gun away. So I think whether you're pro-gun ownership or you're anti-gun ownership, if you're a communist, you're going to agree with that ending statement, that at the end, we won't need guns, but there also won't be anyone there to take it away. Now, we as communists believe in guns. Anyone who says that they are a communist and doesn't believe in the ownership of firearms is a reactionary. And I'm just going to have to put that out there. If you believe in an ideology that has a certain percentage of people who believe in violent revolution, because that has been the past of Marxism, the violent revolution against the state, and then to not support the legal ownership of guns for people, the right for people to have guns, you certainly have no business calling yourself a Marxist. You don't have any, you really can't be sitting there calling yourself a communist, because then you'd be with the reactionaries taking arms away from the people. That's one of the things that Mao did, or all revolutions did, but Mao to a larger degree just by sheer numbers, was arm the masses against their enemies. The nationalist government in China was not overthrown by a tea party, or a dinner party as Mao liked to say. It was overthrown by the armed masses rising up against them and smashing them. That's how it gets done. As Mao said, political power grows out of the barrel of a gun. And that's very, very true in all through history, whether Marxist or anti-Marxist. That has always been true. So I'm going to say I agree with Newt Gingrich in arming the entire world, especially the third world. And if you don't believe in the people being armed, you cannot call yourself a communist, and you certainly cannot call yourself a radical or even a revolutionary.